You know, Rob, this is a little thing, but it's kind of funny when you think about it. You know, one of the standard things that goes along with comic book movies is quite often, you know, the uniforms and the suits that they'll wear. Quite often, sure, they'll put a little bit of extra padding because these superheroes are supposed to be larger than life, right? They're larger than life. They have all this mystique behind them. And so, you know, when you get them in their costumes, you know, you pad them up a little bit. Zach Levi in Shazam, one such example. Well, not surprisingly, but you know one superhero that ain't going to have any padding in their suit?
Let me guess, John. You say it.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson. It's actually been come out now that it's official. Dwayne Johnson ain't going to have any body padding in his Black Adam suit. Now, apparently, his personal trainer was being interviewed, and his personal trainer is Dave Renzi, and he said the following. He said, "It's a fun process when you have someone like The Rock who is so driven, disciplined, and determined to do the work. There's a continuously evolving vision, and we are always working towards. We've been building up to the Black Adam movie for a while with this goal of creating a real-life superhero physique with no padded superhero suit necessary." And Rob, one of the things that he says in there that I find really interesting, talk about Dwayne The Rock Johnson's, like his determination, his discipline, and all that kind of stuff. I might have told this story before, but I was in Vegas because, you know, Ann and I will go to Vegas like 6-7 times a year, COVID notwithstanding. And I got contacted saying, "Hey, Dwayne's in Vegas. He's doing some interviews for an upcoming movie. Would you be interested in heading over to his hotel to do an interview?" I'm like, "Of course I would." And they're like, "Okay, like be there around 8 a.m. I'm like, "Great." So I get to the hotel and I'm down in the lobby waiting for his PR person to get in touch with me. And in through the main doors of the hotel into the lobby comes Dwayne The Rock Johnson in total workout gear, like sweating profusely, muscles like this big bulging. That dude had been in the gym since 5:30 in the morning to get in what he referred to as a quick workout or a quick sweat before, you know, doing some interviews that day. Like that's just his discipline. The guy, say what you will about Dwayne The Rock Johnson and how good of an actor you think he's become. I actually think he's become a very serviceable leading man for Hollywood. But whatever you think of his acting, I always respect work ethic. And this is a dude who never takes a day off. He just, you know, he knows what his strengths are and he'll put work and effort into it. And it pays off when you look at this guy on screen. And now we're going to get a Black Adam without any padding. And Rob, I can only assume that's just going to kind of add to the, as you would often say, the verisimilitude of looking at this truly Greek god kind of superhero physique on screen without any assistance necessary. So I suppose we shouldn't be surprised to hear this, but it's pretty cool to hear them actually saying you're doing it without any padding at all. Anyway, Rob, you hear about this. What's your first reaction to it?
Well, I mean, you know, I think all of us, whether it's on Instagram or on social media, are familiar with how Dwayne The Rock Johnson looks when he works out. You know, you can't not. And by the way, I find it inspiring because, like you said, his work ethic is beyond reproach. The guy just is a machine. I mean, look at this picture you have up right now. Look at that.
This guy is when they made the announcement at DC Fandom, when they made all the announcements and presentation about Black Adam, and he was just standing there in a long sleeve shirt.
But you know what's really interesting to me? I mean, maybe it's vanity, but I think Dwayne understands that this is a business he's running, and his business is himself. And I think that the work ethic that he shows, he gets his body in this kind of condition because that's what he's selling. That's his product. That's what we want from him. And, you know, I'll never forget when I first saw him in Fast and the Furious. I'm like, I don't know how this is going to be. I loved his character, despite the fact that he constantly had water pouring from his veins on his face. I'm like, this makes him even better. This makes him even better. And I love the guy's work ethic. He's always got a big smile on his face. He gives so much back to his fans. I mean, this is a consummate entertainer. This is a man who devotes himself to his audience. And he deserves, in my mind, everything that he gets. He's a family man. He's a father. And he gives us 100%. How many people can say that in their lives, that they give 100% to their job? And sure, you can be cynical and say, well, he certainly gets paid enough. But I'm like, Yes, because he's put in the time and the work and decades to get to the where he is now. So good on Dwayne Johnson. He's all I'm thinking about, John, is hot toy figure.
Oh yeah. Black Adam.
They're gonna have to make Hot Toys is gonna have to make a new body simply to give us a Black Adam figure. And I can't wait.
All right, guys, not a huge piece of news. I just thought it was fun to talk about. What do you guys think about this? Dwayne The Rock Johnson is official. He's gonna have, like, for his superhero outfit in Black Adam, no padding necessary. How do you guys feel about that? Is that like, well, obviously he doesn't need any? Or it's like, wow, like, he's so big, he doesn't even need any. What do you guys think about that? Jump down into the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. Okay, guys.